has always been a medium with vast amount of potential. Filming has only been around for a little over 100 years, but in that time it has captivated hearts and shaped the aspects of cultures. In the same way film impacts audiences, technology has a great impact on film. From the silent era, new advancements propelled films into the talkie era with the addition of audio, and not too later on, color became the newest addition to film. Now within the past 30 years, with the more recent addition of computers, newer techniques have changed filmmaking and guided it into a new era of video production. Unlike the addition of audio and color, which were more widely accepted by audiences right away, the use of computer-generated images have had a slower warming up to the moviegoers. Even in recent years, the use of CGI has been poked fun at and criticized for multiple issues. While there are some points to be made from this, CGI has dynamically and drastically reshaped the film industry, and moreover has changed it for the better. A common complaint about CGI is that its capabilities are misused, and at times overused to a point where people find it to be ridiculous. A prime example of this is Michael Bay's Transformers series, which uses over-the-top special effects that often involve large amounts of computer animation. At times the screen is just littered with explosions, and while some may like this, there seems to be a general consensus that such overuse of special effects puts way too much focus on the visual element of the film, and this in turn can greatly take away from the story and its narration.
It is the next technological step. And there's some spectacle, you know, blockbuster spectacle has always been basically just a stage for Hollywood to show off new technology. And that's what it is, you know, that's what something like Transformers is now, is it's a stage for Hollywood to show off the most up-to-date, latest innovations in CGI.
Another issue that moviegoers tend to have with CGI is that at times one can tell that something is fake. This is more of an issue with earlier CGI use, but it seems that, especially with younger audiences, people are able to spot out certain things that are obviously added in during post-production. Going back to Transformers, during the highway scene, there are times when it is blatantly clear some explosions were added into the shot later on, as well as certain parts where Transformers are in the background, and it is also clear that they are added in afterwards. The last major problem that people tend to have with CGI use is that there is a lack of spatial feeling. Basically, what the issue some have with CGI effects is that it lacks organic feeling that other filming techniques have, such as using puppets for special effects, or having actual locations in the background as opposed to using a green screen. A clear issue that arises from this is the lack of actor interaction with the environment as well as other characters that are not actually there. When Star Wars made a comeback to the film world with the new movie The Phantom Menace, certain characters were completely computer generated, such as Jar Jar Binks. The look that Jar Jar has is outdated by today's standards, but more importantly, the interaction he has with the other characters makes it apparent that Jar Jar is not really there. Anthony Brandt tackles this issue with one of his articles, and one interesting thing he says is when he makes mention of another film analyst, when Brandt says, "In the end though, the best special effects are the ones that call the least attention to themselves. As Shout puts it, when an effect person does his work well, you're not aware that there's an effect there. You believe." The issue of CGI and actor interaction has been an obstacle filmmakers have been trying to traverse for decades, and some more recent techniques have come up with some solutions. In the early 2000s, when the film adaptation of Lord of the Rings books started to go into production, there was an initial issue of how to depict the creature Gollum, who is a somewhat deformed human-like creature that plays a key role in the books and films. Director Peter Jackson, as well as actor Andy Serkis, felt that Gollum needed to be played by an actor, but also be computer animated. The solution they came up with was the first completely lifelike computer-generated character. What they did was have Andy Serkis act the part of Gollum within the scenes of the movie, but as they were being filmed, a computer would pick up movements Serkis was making due to added reflective points placed on Serkis. This technique was largely successful, and the stunning visuals portrayed by the character Gollum within the array of films speaks for itself. This technique was later adapted to other films, namely other works involving Andy Serkis, such as King Kong and Rise of the Planet of the Apes. This method of incorporating computer animation into a film is just one of the many examples of advancements in CGI techniques that have helped to try and eliminate viewer negativity towards things like fake-looking CGI or overuse of computer animation. With the initial negatives put into perspective, one may wonder why CGI is used at all, but in actuality, the use of CGI within films is something that has added a tremendous amount of help and convenience to filmmaking. There are many factors that contribute to CGI's usefulness, and one of the key factors in this is convenience. With the use of computer animation, the possibilities are limitless and entire worlds can be created using computer animation. In fact, as time goes on, there has been an increasing number of films that are solely animated. The animation in some of these movies has been so realistic that sometimes one can forget that certain things are animated, and this pertains to live-action movies as well. Caesar from Rise of the Planet of the Apes looks and feels so genuine and organic that it is difficult at times to think that he is computer-generated. Generally, what draws directors and producers into using CGI is its practicality, and a part of this comes from the fact that CGI is generally quite cost-effective. Instead of having to buy the materials to go out and create special effects or scenery, all one has to do instead is get a good computer animation software and create the effects themselves. The drawback is that there is a pretty high learning curve, and the effects do take some time to create, but even hiring a professional to do the effects on a computer is definitely more cost-effective than creating the effects live. So the use of CGI is beneficial cost-wise to filmmakers at any professional level, making it the perfect alternative to live effects. One thing that people do not realize is that there are certain stunts and special effects that are done that are quite dangerous. There are some very dangerous things involved in filmmaking, such as using live animals. Even something as simple as filming on the ocean can be hazardous, not to mention time-consuming. Vicky Jane touches up on this subject in one of her articles, saying, "The reality is that both cost and safety consideration preclude a lot of live film footage, and the real action/CGI blend within movies like The Hobbit or Doko's The Shackleton's Captain keeps getting smarter and more subtle." Jane mentions a film titled Shackleton's Captain and states that due to the film being mainly comprised of hazardous ocean scenes, it would be very dangerous to film the movie unless computer animation was used. When it comes to using CGI, sometimes it just comes down to what is the safest option, and besides carpal tunnel, I'm sure that there isn't anything too harmful about computer animation. With all these things in mind, one may say that computer animation is absolutely great, but in reality it is not an all-powerful form of visual representation. CGI is a wonderful medium that has many useful implications, but at the same time, its power cannot be abused. What makes certain films throughout history so great was that they were able to find a balance to all the forms used within their films. Jurassic Park is a good example of finding this balance because the CGI wasn't overused or abused, and this balance was what makes the film look so incredible for its time. I'm not saying that older techniques are obsolete either. Even Peter Jackson, the man behind the creation of Gollum, uses puppets from time to time. If there is a message to gain from this, it is not that CGI is the greatest thing ever, because in some ways it is not. It just seems that sometimes people view CGI as a bad thing, and sometimes poke fun at it. But CGI is a growing and evolving field that, yes, has some ways to go, but should not be overlooked. What should really be taken away from this is that CGI has a lot of potential, and it has proven its worth time and time again.